If you thought yesterday's news video was the biggest amount of info we were going to get on this update, you were wrong, because the newswire Rockstar just dropped today is absolutely massive. Kayo Perico is getting a huge nerf. KD ratios are getting a massive change, making them pretty much pointless now. And that's only just scratching the surface of what Rockstar just told us. So we're going to go through this entire newswire again today, back-to-back days of massive DLC news. I feel like I'm covering a company that's not Rockstar Games. Like, I don't know what's going on, but I'm here for it. This DLC is shaping up to be one of the biggest and best in GTA Online history, despite not really having any new content, which is absolutely bizarre. So let's get into this. If you enjoy this video, a thumbs up would be awesome. Subscribe for more stuff like this. And let's go. So to start off the newswire, Rockstar just says this is a massive list of upcoming improvements to the GTA Online experience. And what I find funny about this is they say this is implementing a bunch of requests that have come via the GTA Online feedback website, which, I mean, I guess Rockstar wants us to use that. I'm personally probably not going to, but if you have any changes you want, I guess go to that link. They say, we have a wide range of improvements and upgrades to the overall experience of GTA Online for all current platforms. So this is coming to every platform. Business protection and upgrades. Starting July 26, players will be able to engage in business activities, including cell missions in invite-only lobbies. We know that. So what's new here? Well, honestly, kind of nothing, except for the fact that Rockstar hints at players on PC, PS4, and Xbox One being able to find invite-only lobbies without going back to single-player. We'll have to wait and see, though. Next up, we get a lot of changes coming to vehicle customization, starting off with all vehicles that are able to go into the LS car meet will be able to equip low-grip tires. So, for people that have been wanting to customize your older vehicles to make them drift a lot easier, well, now you can do that. So any vehicle that can go in the LS car meet can now put on these tires. Huge. Vehicles will be delivered faster when requesting them from the mechanic, so you don't have to wait that like 5-10 second awkward period after requesting a vehicle, which is nice. Now this one's a big change. Players will no longer be charged for destroying another player's weaponized personal vehicle, avoiding penalties for those who return fire and successfully kill attackers. So this is pretty big. If you're in a weaponized vehicle now, you are not safe at all though. But overall, this is definitely a good change. I'm sure all of us have been like attacked by an oppressor Mark II, and then we have to turn on them and blow up their vehicle, and then we have to pay $20,000, which was nerfed to $10,000, but still, we have to pay for their insurance even though we were just defending ourselves. It was dumb, it was stupid, and now it's gone. The Avenger and MOC vehicle workshops will now accommodate any vehicle that can fit, opposed to select vehicles like the oppressor Mark II. So you can drive pretty much every single vehicle into one of these workshops now and customize it. So it is now completely your own little personal LS customs, which is nice. Now we knew we were getting 20 new garage spots or 20 new vehicle spots in your garage, but we didn't exactly know how this was going to happen. Now Rockstar has confirmed that you're able to own 10 properties instead of 8, which in turn can give you 20 more vehicle slots. The Legendary Motorsport and Southern San Andreas Super Autos websites will feature new filters and browsing shortcuts, which can be tabbed using L1, R1, or LB, RB on console. So this is nice. I'm interested to see exactly what these filters are. Maybe it just divides them up into sport, super, compact, SUV, you know, just makes it easier to find the exact type of vehicle you want. Or who knows, maybe they're gonna change it so it's like the discounted section, or they're gonna maybe divide them up into the DLCs they were released in, but my bet is on the vehicle class. We get some more details on the Oppressor Mark II nerf. So they're reducing the homing missile effectiveness, we knew that. The countermeasures will have increased cooldowns and fewer uses, so that's the nerf coming with that. And also the Sparrow that comes with the Kasatka is getting countermeasures, which is a big, big change. The Sparrow is one of the best helicopters in the game for grinding money. It's super quick and it has unlimited rockets. They shoot quick. It's just a good helicopter. But the one downside is you're a sitting duck when you're in it. Now, countermeasures hopefully let you have a bit more survivability. General improvements. This is where things start to get a bit spicy. When delivering security contracts back to the agency, you can now enter your agency via helicopter or through the walk-in entrance, rather than needing to go through the front door at ground level. So that's a nice little change, I guess. When managing your auto shop, your auto shop staff will be much more likely to successfully deliver a customer's vehicle without it taking damage, which is huge because this was pretty much useless up until this point. These drivers absolutely sucked. This just makes me laugh, man. To get around certain locations easier, players will be able to jog inside the Diamond Casino, the Music Locker, and nightclubs. Our character finally has learned how to run again inside the casino. This is big. I'm happy for this. I don't know, man. Slow walking all the way across the casino, it didn't feel good. Now we can run. It's gonna be good. Players will now be able to purchase max ammo for all weapons at once in the interaction menu. That's very nice. Players will also have easier access to snacks and armor through a single input in the weapon wheel. How huge is that? It's literally going to be in the weapon wheel, and Rockstar even showed us exactly what this is going to look like. So you've got your weapon wheel up, and then up on the top left of your screen, press up arrow to eat a snack or R3 to use armor. That simple, that easy. This is a huge, huge change. Man, no more going into the interaction menu, pressing inventory, snacks, and then, you know, hiding and then eating snacks for 5 minutes. It's gone. It's done. That era is over after almost 9 years. Thank you. Another really great change that Rockstar is implementing here is if you fail a mission and quick restart it, your snacks and armor will be restocked to however many you had when you started. So if you keep failing the Kaya Perico heist, for example, you don't need to go back out to your Kasatka and get more armor and snacks. Like, it was dumb in the first place and it's gone now, which is nice. The annoying phone calls are getting a bit of a nerf. You can now immediately hang up on phone calls from several contacts. Mainly, I'm assuming this is going to be for Dave. Dave, stop calling me, bro. Lose my number. I don't like you. PC players can now disable the in-game chat box in the settings menu. Now, this should have been done, like, probably when the game actually came out. Pretty much every PC game lets you do this. But this is going to be great for PC players because now you're not going to get spammed by people advertising their mods. Oh, griefers, I'm sorry, hold on to your seats, like, just hold on to something, strap yourself in, because you're about to get your world rocked, alright? Ready? To reduce instances of griefing, the kill-death statistic will no longer be affected by kills made in free mode. Going forward, this ratio will only be affected by kills scored in competitive gameplay. XX, barcode XX, wearing the griefer outfit. Are you okay, my bro? Are you okay? Rockstar basically just told you, suck my dick. This will actually reduce griefing a lot, in my opinion, and this should have been done literally when the game came out, because I have no reason why your KD can be raised by killing someone who is, like, literally shopping for clothes, racing their friends, walking down the street, trying to do a cell mission, just not wanting to fight you, minding their own business, and you can come kill them with a flying bike with homing missiles, or, I mean, genuinely, a missile from space, a cannon, an orbital cannon, and boost your KD. It was dumb. It's gone. Griefers, L. After their initial visit, players will be able to spend more time scoping out Kaya Perico, so you can get caught more times before getting kicked off the island, which, I mean, cool. We're also getting some changes to the race creator. It's increasing the checkpoint limit and player limit for transform races. Plus, you can now create RC Bandito races via the special race creator, as well as a ghost to first checkpoint option being added for additional race types. Rockstar is also adding a new anti-grief ghosting option to ghost players driving in the wrong direction, so race griefing is gonna be getting a massive nerf, which is, I mean, it's a good change. Let's talk about the money. Payout increases. This is huge. The criminal enterprises will also include increased payouts across a number of activities in GTA Online. We already knew that, but now we get the exact details on what these increases are going to be. Let's have a look. Races. All standard race types, including player-created races, will pay out an average of 50% more money. The total prize pool for premium races will also be increased. And overall, for races, I feel like this is just a little bit too low of an increase. Something closer to double money, in my opinion, would have been better for this. But still, we'll have to wait and see. 50% is better than nothing. Adversary modes, same thing. An average of 50% boost across all adversary modes. And again, I think this is far too low. I would have liked to have seen at least double again. Maybe even triple for some adversary modes. These are some of the most fun activities in GTA Online, and it breaks my heart that these pay, like, absolutely nothing compared to doing a heist. Because if players were able to make really good money doing these, as well as having a lot of fun, then these playlists would be way more populated, and people would be having a lot more fun, in my opinion. Again though, we'll have to wait and see. An average of 50% is still better than nothing, so time will tell. Heists. Okay, this is where it gets a little confusing, but very, very important. To encourage group play, all players joining heist setups will receive 50% more money than the current payout, which is really nice, helping out other people with their heists. Huge. Definitely a much needed change. Additionally, the minimum cut for finales is now set at 15% for each member, and the cost of heist setup fees has been reduced across the board to 25k. Not bad. These four heists here, the Fleecer Job, Humane Labs Raid, Prison Break Finale, and Series A Funding Finale, will be getting a 75% payout increase. This was definitely much needed. Now, will these be a viable way to grind out money now? No, and that's not what anyone was really asking for. We were just trying to make sure that these didn't pay like absolute trash, and they still don't pay absolutely amazing for your time spent in them, but still, it's better than what they were before. These four heists will be getting a 50% payout increase, so the Pack Standard and the Doomsday Act 1, 2, and 3. For those of you that don't know how much these paid out originally, Act 3 paid out $1.5 million on hard mode, so a 50% increase will put that up to $2.25 million. That's a lot more in line with something like a Kaya Perico or a Diamond Casino heist. I'm gonna have to do some testing when this comes out to see if it's viable. I'm gonna say no, Kaya Perico and Casino will still be a little bit better, but this definitely levels the playing field a lot. Okay, my fellow grinders, it's time for us to hold on to our seats and strap in because we have some interesting news. It's good and bad at the same time. You're gonna have to make up your own mind whether you like this change. But yeah, heists are getting a nerf. With this update, all heists will be aligned to have the same cooldown timer of one in-game day, which is 48 minutes when playing as a group. So for all heists in the game and Kaya Perico when you're playing more than solo, so if you're playing with two people, it's going to have a cooldown of 48 minutes before you can start them again. That reduces a single heist's money-making capabilities by a lot. Now this is where it gets even more interesting. We will also adjust specific aspects of the Kaya Perico heist finale to better balance a player's time spent in GTA Online. Solo playthroughs of the Kaya Perico heist finale will trigger a cooldown of 3 in-game days. So if you complete the Kaya Perico heist solo, you're gonna now have to wait 3 in-game days or 144 minutes or 2 hours and 24 minutes before you can start this heist up again. Not only that, after stealing a high-value primary target in the Kaya Perico heist, so something like the Panther, the Pink Diamond, and maybe even Bearer Bonds, after you steal them, the higher-value primary targets will appear less often for the next 72 hours, while the value of secondary targets will increase. So the likelihood that you're gonna get another diamond again goes down by a lot, but then the value of things like gold, artwork, coke, all of that sort of stuff will increase. I'm gonna have to do some testing again. We'll have to wait and see once this comes out, but these are some huge changes. And I don't quite know how to feel about this Kaya Perico nerf. About 2.5 hours before I can complete it again, that means I'm gonna have to go do my MC business grind, my bunker grind, maybe even a casino heist. I'm not too sure what effect this is gonna have on how much money you can make per hour, but I know it's definitely gonna decrease it a little bit. I'm not gonna act like this is the end of the world because we still have other great ways to make money. Like we can do Franklin contracts, we can do payphone hits, we can do a casino heist, we can do these MC bunker business missions that have got buffs. So lots of people are gonna act like this is the end of the world, but the reality is Rockstar is making it so that everything is a bit more level now. So I'm actually not too upset by this nerf. We all know that Kaya Perico was by far the best way to make money in the game, and the problem that had was people were only playing Kaya Perico. People weren't actually playing the rest of the game, which is kind of why the game got boring. This is exactly what I said in my video, why you're bored of GTA Online. I don't know if Rockstar watched that video. If you did, Rockstar, I mean, thank you. This is a very interesting change that will make the game more fun, but it will most definitely decrease the amount of money players can make. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. I'm not too sure how to think about this right now. Like, I can see the good, I can see the bad. I guess I'm going to have to play it and figure it out for myself. And we're not done yet, man. This is an absolutely huge newswire. We have so many changes coming. Next up, boosts for organizations and MC members. Baseline salaries for bodyguards, associates, and MC members will be doubled, ensuring players are able to earn GTA money fairly while working for other players. This is nice. Personally, I still think it should be more than double, because even doubling this doesn't make it a viable way of making money, but still better than nothing. In addition to doubled salaries, MC members will also receive an increased payout for taking part in cell missions. This is going to be very interesting. I'm sure we've all been there, and it just doesn't feel nice when you're helping a mate sell, you know, a full coke lockup worth of stock. He gets $500,000 and you helped him and you got just, you know, a few thousand dollars or whatever it was. It just didn't feel right. So we'll have to wait and see what these changes are, but definitely a good one. Bodyguards and associates will now also receive increased payouts for participating in cell missions, just like the MC businesses. Another little change, fees related to renaming your organizations have also been reduced, which, I mean, personally, I think they should be pretty much free. And to finish off the newswire, we have first-time payout boosts. Players will receive an email on their phone detailing first-time payout boosts across criminal careers. Executives will get a 3x payout for the new export mixed goods cell mission. This can be accessed through your executive assistant after one of your new warehouse staff members have acquired their first batch of special cargo. So I'm not sure exactly what this is going to look like because this is a little bit of new content, so we'll have to wait and see. But for bikers, businesses will produce stock at 3 times their regular speed, returning to normal rates after your first sell mission is completed. So my tip to you guys is take advantage of this. Don't sell anything until all of your businesses are full, because as soon as you sell something, it's going to go back to the normal speed. So wait till all of them are full, then sell. Gunrunners, bunkers, pretty much the same sort of thing. Research speeds are tripled for your first research item. Production speeds are also tripled, returning to normal rates after your first sell mission is completed. So don't sell until your bunker is completely full. You're just missing out on free money if you do. Nightclub owners, all business battle goods will contain triple the usual amount, which, I mean, that's... I honestly think that should be a permanent thing. Business battles don't give you that much money. Returning to normal rates after your first sell mission is completed. And then this is a big one. Your first sell mission for each of the businesses listed above will reward double the usual GTA payout. So you get a double money sell mission for every single business once this update comes out. That is huge. That's a lot of money, man. We're also getting some bonus limited time payout boosts as well. So motorcycle work, club challenges, clubhouse contracts, and member challenges will award double payouts for a limited time. My bet is that's going to be for about a week. VIP work will also award double as well. So your headhunter and sightseer, that's going to be double money for, again, in my opinion, probably about a week. And we are finally at the end of the newswire. Man, I think that is the longest video I have ever made covering news. I'm looking at the recording and this is close to what, like 17 minutes? That is a lot of news, man. This DLC is shaping up to be one of the best ever, and we're getting almost no actual new content. Like, we're not getting a new story, we're not getting a new heist, we're just getting some contract missions and some small changes to businesses. But despite that, this is gonna be one of the best updates ever. We don't hear from Rockstar much. We only hear from them pretty much when the DLCs come out around July and December. But lately, when we have heard from them, it's been pretty good stuff that's coming to GTA Online. So shout out to you, Rockstar. It looks like you're finally cleaning up all the mess in GTA Online, and I'm certainly happy you are. All right, we'll wrap it up there. If you enjoyed this video, a thumbs up would be awesome. Subscribe for more stuff like this, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace. Find me on the mountaintop, need no calculation.